Roll the shoulders back. Roll it forward. Squeeze up. Just a little tap. Get a bit deeper, go. Charmaine has chosen eight. So what we do is this. We've got all the cards on the floor, and all we do is count eight cards along, and we do that card first, and then from there we count eight again, and we keep on going along until we get all the cards through. Okay? So the first card, which is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Bicep curls! Grab your band for bicep curls. Hey, Mr. Cupid, how you doing? Elbows by your side. Get ready. We've got 10 reps. Deep breath in. Off we go. 1, 2. Three, elbows stay by your side. 4, 5, 6. Elbows stay by your side.
7,
making sure there's 8, no movement in the shoulder.
9, 10.
Okay. Where were we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Into squat jumps. Into squat jumps. Bicep first, please.
All right.
Bicep curls. Then squat jumps. Get ready. 1, 2. Elbows stay here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Weights down. Squat jump. Remember, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Sing it down. 5, 6, 7. Good. 8, 9, Perfect. Beautiful. Counting on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, excuse me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Next one. Press ups. Bicep curls, get ready.
I'm forgetting this.
Give me a 10. Deep breath in. 1, 2, 3. Control. 4. Slower. 5. Good. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Squat jumps. Let's go. 1, 2, 3. Sit back. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Into press ups. Let's go. 1, 2, 3. Count for me. So notice, elbows are pointing backwards, not out to the side.
8, 9, 10.
Up and get. Where are we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Squats. Bicep curls. Turn sideways, please. Sideways. Get ready. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. 5, 6. Control. 7, 9. Sorry. 8. Good. 9. Squat jumps. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Chest up. 5. Good. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Press ups. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stand up. Give me some squats. No way. Let's go. 1. Good. 2, 3, 4, 5. Six, go down, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well done, people. Beautiful, 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 beautiful. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Meet and greet, people. It's going to be 5 on each leg. Get ready for the bicep curls. Deep breath in. Let's go, and hold on. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Beautiful. Squat jumps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Try to keep your heels on the floor each time. Press ups. Deep breath. Get down. Let's go. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. One more. 10. Lovely. Squats. Let's go. Sink it down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Head up. 8, 9, 10. Meet and greet. Now remember, meet and greet. Knee more. Five, change sides. Knee to the ankle. One, two, three, four, five. And relax it down. How are we doing, people? How are we doing? Where are we? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay. Nice and easy. Bicep curls with control. Slowly up, slowly down. Up. Down. Slowly, slowly. Two. Three. Slowly, please. Four. Five, six, good, seven, eight, don't go too fast, nine, one more, ten, jump squats, one, two, three, four, five, six, heels out, seven, eight, nine, 10, press ups, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 9, slow it down, 10, we've got squats, nice control, let's go, let's get down, 1, good, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, meet and greet. One, two, three, four, five. Change sides. Let's go. One, two. Turn it in. Three, four, five. Lean it up. Let's go. Five each time. One. One, two. Let's go. One, two, three, four, five. Change sides. One, two, three, four, five. Make sure when you're doing knee lifts, you're not bringing your knee down, your elbow down to your knee. Your elbow stays high and you're rotating through. The knee is coming up, okay? The knee is coming up, working the hip flexor. Alternate leg thrusts. We've got the biceps first. Get ready. Nice control. Slowly. Follow me. Let's go. One. Two. Three. Four. Five, six, go up, seven, eight, nine, one more, nice, squat jumps, down, let's go, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Press ups. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 9. One more. 10. Good. I was counting correctly.
Yeah,
give me those squats. 1. 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. 10. Meet and greet. 1. 2.
Down. 1,
two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, water break. Okay, so I'm going to do one round with you, with my bad back self. Get ready, people. Bicep curls. Let's go for 10. What? Nine, 10. Squat jumps. Simple, sit back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. On the press up, make sure elbows are pointing back. Get ready. One, two, three. Chest out. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Squats. Get ready. Nice control. Sit back and cut. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Meet and greet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Change side, let's go, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Knee lifts here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Change side, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alternate leg thrust. Bring it in, let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, 1. Deadlift with the squats. Let's go down and 1. Squats, good. 2, 3, 4. Just that squat. 5. Seven, 9, last one here, last squat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's the curtsy. The curtsy. Bicep curls first, yes? Remember, elbows stay by your side, not glued in, slightly away from your side. Nice control. Get ready, let's go. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, one more, 10. Beautiful. Spot jumps. 2, 3, 4.
Ten. One.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Meet and greet 1, 2, 3, 4. One more. 5. Change sides. Let's go. 1, 2. Turn the body. 3, 4, 5. Knee lifts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Change sides.
I don't want any more.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't know. Leg thrust. Bring it in. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's get those deadlift squats in. Let's go there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Change sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Triceps. Let's go. 1. Elbow stays pointing towards the ceiling. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And relax. Circuit is done. Okay? So what I'm going to do now is, because I feel I haven't given you all of me.
Oh, should I leave the room then?
You're good. Right, so what I'm going to do is this, okay? I'm just going to break down some techniques for you to make sure that when we go to do this again, or when you do it again on your own, you can try to utilise the techniques that I'm going to give you to make sure that you're working the muscles to the extreme maximum.
Yeah.
Yeah? You take a seat there, babe.
I will.
Okay.
No.
Where you were the first time was fine.
I'm just
okay. Okay, so we've got firstly the bicep curl. Okay? So when you do the bicep curl, try not to wedge your arms into your side like this and start taking the weights out this way here. Because what we're doing there, we're using our body as a brace, and that will give you more leverage to do the exercise. What we want to do is concentrate on the muscle that we're working, which is the bicep, okay? This muscle right here. So, that being said, hold on there one sec. That being said, we don't want to have our arms out like this. We want to have it in its natural position. Arms by your side. If you put your arms by your side, we have lats, we have bits of our body that stick out. Our arms will naturally go to this position. So that's where we want to be. Okay? Naturally here. Then what we do is bring our front of our arms to us towards our shoulder, our wrist towards our shoulder, our forearms towards our bicep, like so. Chest nice and tall, back nice and straight. This part of your arm stays still and it moves like that. It's not back here, it's slightly forward because we want to work against gravity. So here, up and down, control. Make sense? Okay. Squats. I'm going to miss out the jump part, it's going to give you the squat element. Okay? Feet where comfortable. Okay? They don't have to be hip width apart or shoulder apart, it's where you feel comfortable. Okay, you squat down. Your knees travel over your toes. I know when you go to aerobic classes and stuff like that, they say keep your knees behind your toes, sit back so you're in this position here, but that's not a natural squatting position. If you look at generations, if you watch your grandchildren or your children or whatever, or your friends, kids or whatever, pick up things from the floor, they don't go. Naturally, they'll pick up something from the floor like this. They get down here and they'll be down in this position here. Okay? So that is a natural position to squat. When you squat, you sit back, your knees above your toes, you're here, and you'll drive up through your heels. Okay? Your chest stays up and proud. Your hips lead you on the way down. Your chest lead on the way up. Sit back. Drive up. Okay? Nice control. It's not a fall down and push up. Control down, control up. Let's go to press-ups. Press-ups. Now, when we're doing press-ups, if I was to stand up for me, please. Let me use my Debbie McGee assistant. Think of the word press, okay? If you're gonna press something or push something, push-ups, press-ups, push-ups, press-ups, let me get my teeth in, you think about how you're going to push something away. You would never ever, in reality, get your elbows up like this and push someone away like that. You wouldn't do it. The natural position for your arms to be is elbows down here. And if you push someone away, it'd be easy if you do it to me, because you can see. If you push someone away, your elbows are going to be in that position here. Okay, from that position there, that's how you're going to push them away. They wouldn't be up here and pushing them away like that. Okay, so when you're doing push-ups, press-ups, keep your elbows downwards towards the length of your body. So going backwards. So when you're doing your press-ups, push-ups, press-ups, your elbows are going backwards, not out, back here, up and down, okay? And your hands should be in line with your nipples or your chest, okay? So push up and down. Blow yourself away from the floor. Yeah? Don't have your hands too far forward, because what happens then, the angle you're pushing, instead of pushing up and down, you're pushing backwards. So the shoulders is going to take more strain than the triceps and the chest. So you want your hands under your chest, because that is where gravity is making you push from. Because obviously gravity works up and down. So we want to have it in a straight line, up and down. So our hands need to be in that position, so we're pushing in a straight fashion.
What about those push-ups?
Well, also, if you're going to do close hand press-ups or push-ups, it's the same thing. You still need your elbows in that same position. The hands still need to be under your chest, because that's what gravity enables you to do. Push up and down, okay? As soon as you start pushing away from you, you're putting a lot of strain on different muscles that you don't want or don't want to use. Not you don't want them, but you don't want to use in that fashion. So make sure, if you're doing close grip, close hand press-ups, your hand is still under your chest. Not under your face, it's under your chest. If it's going to be under your face, then you need to be in this position.
So you're coming down there. Or if you do it on your knees, you're doing it so it comes down there. It needs to be in a straight line from where you're working from. If that makes sense. So close hand, for me, normal, will be here. My elbows are still going back, and I'm pushing through here.
And these are more for the triceps.
Those work more triceps than chest, because the angle that you're working is predominantly pushing from the triceps. A push-up does work the triceps a lot more than chest anyway. But depending on where you put them, you can make it utilize your chest a bit more. Your triceps will burn out before your chest does, because it's a smaller muscle. What we got next? Let's do a meet and greet. So, one of Fitzroy's ones. So, the knee meets here. Okay, so the weight now is like a single leg squat. The weight is all on the front leg. Your body turns to go over the front leg here. The weight should be all here. Nothing in this whatsoever. It should be just really loose. Even though you're going to have a little bit of weight on there, you want majority of the weight to be on the front leg. So it's going to be here and step up. Okay, come down here and step up. What you can do to intensify the front leg and take the weight off the back leg more is when you come down, take the knee out to the side and be on your toes. So the weight is predominantly on that front leg, on that glute, hitting this side here. As you come up, you step in. Okay, again on this side here. Come down, here, normal, this way here. If you've got weight, the weight will be either side of the leg, coming up. And if you want to intensify, take the knee out slightly more, you get lower down on this one here. You can't really push off your toes, okay? You can push the ball of your foot, but the toes, it's hard to push off. And so therefore, the weight will be on that front leg a lot more, okay? Knee lift's pretty standard. You can either do it at the front here or to the side. But I would say, if you're going to do knee lifts, it's about knee lift, not about the crunch. If you're going to do this, that isn't really called a knee lift, even though you are lifting your knee, but you're crunching down at the same time, so it'll be a side crunch. If you're going to do a knee lift, you want to keep your body nice and tall and lift the knee up. And if you're rotating in, rotate, but don't crunch down. Depending on what exercise you're doing, but for me, a knee lift is this motion or this motion, not so much crunching down or squeezing to it. Alternate leg thrust? Right, so the alternate leg thrust. Mountain climbers. Lots of different names for this exercise. For me, again, as press-ups, the hand should be under the shoulders here, so it's in a straight line, okay? So the elbows are pointing backwards, not out to the side. Here, arms should be near enough locked. Just slightly soft elbows, not completely locked, just slightly soft. And the knees, as you come in, want to come in as close to your elbows or in line with your elbows as possible. So it's coming in under your chest, okay? So it doesn't make sense just doing a little movement here. You want to try and get in as far as you can. So you're working your hip flex, lower abs, and also you're getting a good stretch on the glutes as well. Okay? What have we got? Curtsy? Go for curtsy?
Yeah.
Right. Curtsy. Now, these are just my thoughts and the way that I would do things. When I do a curtsy lunge, a curtsy squat, I like to make sure that the weight is predominantly on the leg that stays still. So when you come down here, this foot needs to stay planted. You sit back on this leg here, and you want to make sure your mind works into that glute, into the hamstring, into that glute. You feel the stretch for the bite, and from there, you push back up again and take it back down again here, okay? This leg shouldn't really be taking any weight at this point. All the weight should be on this leg, all the time, here. Come down and back up again. Just gently. If you want to intensify that pressure, keep it on the toes of that that leg. When it comes out here, keep it on the toes, sink it down, and push up again, okay? As you add weight, obviously you wanna have a steady base, so therefore you might wanna place the ball of the foot down on the floor and come up, okay? The further you take it over, the more stretch you'll feel, but it's not about the stretch, it's about pushing and taking that mind to that muscle, take it down here, and push it back up again, okay? Same thing on the opposite side. Because you've seen people meet the queen, and when they meet the queen, they curtsy, they don't go like that. It's dainty. Yeah, very dainty. Sit back here. Yeah, that's the curtsy for me. And triceps, let's finish on the triceps, last one. When you're working the tricep band overhead press, for me, again, this part of your arm needs to be back, in line with your ears, hands going up towards the ceiling, extend out. You can either extend both together, like so, or extend out. All that the difference is the tricep has three heads. You are kind of, when you're flicking out, you're rotating the movement to hit different parts of the tricep. That's all it is. Both, it's a lot stronger if you do two together, like that. It's a lot stronger, but if you start taking it apart, you're isolating smaller parts of the tricep and it makes it slightly harder. So you might have to use lighter weight for that. That's a workout. Anyway, any further questions, don't be afraid to drop me a message or anything, or if you think that I was stating something incorrectly, feel free to correct me, and we'll have it out online. No jokes. I'm joking. But anyway, listen, seriously, thanks a lot for working today. Sorry that I couldn't jump in and do the exercises with you, but 2 days rest, I'm sure I'll be back to fighting fit and Frankson workouts. We'll be back as normal. Yeah?
Yeah.
Thank you. Enjoy, people. Enjoy the rest of your day. Enjoy the 2 days off. And I'll speak to you all soon. Okay? Thanks a lot.